Hi, I am Aref Hakimzadeh and I present the paper Enhanced Principal Curve Weight Classifiers for Time Series Label Prediction. What is the problem? The state of the art algorithms for predicting the time series, predicting the label in the time series, have hard coded architectures, which I mean the time spans between the consecutive data points is not meant to vary, is not meant to change. So what if after training the classifier, the sampling rate of one of the sampling devices changes, and so forth? Our test data has different time spans between data points from the training data. So in this situation, what happens to the accuracy and F score of the classifier? The purpose of our paper is to handle the relative characteristics of the time. So why this problem is important? As I said before, changing the sampling rate may force forces us to retrain the whole classifier from the beginning, or forces us to discard a big portion of the data points. What is time series label prediction? Time series label prediction is a special case in predicting and in classifying sequential data. An important point is that time itself is not just the sequencer of our data set. It has a concept and it has valuable data for recognition of the events in the time space. And as you know, the recurrent neural networks are the state of the art algorithms in predicting the labels in time series. So what is our contribution to this problem? Unlike the neural network, we seek an algorithm to consider the time and consider its concept is relativity, and take the time into the classifying process. The proposed algorithm is supposed to handle any time dilation. Time dilation is a concept in the time-space debate, and it was it's related to the general relativity. For our implementation, we use a principal curve for modeling the data and modeling and using principal curve for our processes to classifying the data. And in the literature review, first we review the concept of principal curve. Principal curve is a non-parametric line which passes through the cloud of data. As you can see, the objective function of the principal curve on the right hand side, it's hard to reach and has and needs a lot of computation to fulfill this objective function. And many algorithms try to define a suboptimum for this objective function and solve the principal curve problem. One of the most prominent ways for extracting the principal curve is called CLPC method, which reduces the computation power by making the algorithm iterable. And the recurrent neural networks, which are the state-of-the-art algorithms, are based on the RNN architectures, and these structures are able to find patterns in time series or in sequential data by passing the history parameter to the next step of the process, as it can be seen in the picture below. And LSTMs are one of the good architectures based on the recurrency, which can preserve both the long-term and short-term dependencies on the data. LSTM cells have shown promising results compared to the RNA.
And the proposed algorithm. Proposed algorithm is consists of several simple steps. The first step is the initialization step, that we model the data with principal care. In the second step, regulate time in data stream is called. In this step, we just want to show that in the proposed algorithm, we are able to change the time spans between each two consecutive data points may vary in any way, and the proposed algorithm is to handle these variations. Next step, matching process. In this step, the algorithm finds the most similar state of the governing pattern to the input data stream. After finding the most similar state by projecting the last data point on the principal curve, we may classify the input data and predict its label. And in the last step, we want to enhance the position of the principal curve considering the wrong predicted labels. So first step, this initialization step, we want to model the data. For the modeling, we use a k-principal curve by using the CLPC method. This picture, a k-principal curve have been fitted to each class of data. Each color determines one class of data.
Next step is the matching process. In this step, we want to find the most similarity between the input data stream and the governing pattern that we extracted in the first step, in the initialization step. In these pictures below, you see one correct matching process and two wrong examples of this process. In these pictures, blue data points are the input data streams with the history length of H, and each of the other colors represent one class of data in the initialization data. As you can see, the leftmost pictures has the most similarity between the blue points and the governing patterns, and the other two pictures have less similarity. After finding the most similar state, we want to predict the label. For that purpose, we project the last input data on all the principal curves, which each one of them represent one class of data. After projection, the closest principal curve to the data point determines the label of data. And in the last step, we want to enhance our principal curve from the wrong predicted data points. So each wrong predicted data point should be closer to its corresponding principal curve. For that purpose, we project the data point on that principal curve, and the vector between them is called the error vector, and the corresponding principal curve moves across the error vector to decrease the error. So for our experimental results, we compare the proposed algorithm with three famous recurrent neural network based classifiers, which are the state of the art classifiers for the time series label prediction. The details of the implementations are in table 1 for LSTM GRU, and also TCN network which is based on convolutional networks, and we want to represent a variable called sampling rate. Sampling rate is defined to test the situation where the sampling rate of the test data is different from the sampling rate of the training data. For better representation, I show the data points in circles, and for test data, if the sampling rate is 1 out of 4, we choose 1 out of 4 of the data points. The purple data points are the selected data points, and the gray data points are the data points that we discard in the test situation. This is meant to be a simulation for the changing of the sampling rate after the training the classifier. So for our first data set, which is called VESA data set, and sampling rate equal to 1, which in all situations except the running time, the proposed algorithm has better accuracy F score and also G score in this data set. In next experiment, we change the sampling rate to 1 out of 30. And again, we see that the proposed algorithm has better results than other classifiers. And the point is here is that the difference between the accuracy of the proposed algorithm with other classifiers is much bigger when the sampling rate is lower. And in this last experiment on this data set, the sampling rate in each step is a random number between 1 and 1 out of 30. As it can be seen in this table, again, the proposed algorithm has better results in this situation, except the processing time. In the next experiment, we experiment another data set called a sleep data set, which is more imbalanced. Again, here the proposed algorithm has better results when the sampling rate is equal to 1. By changing the sampling rate equal to half, we see that for accuracy, GRU has better results. But in F-score and G-score, the proposed algorithm has better results. And that's because this data set is imbalanced, and the GRU has classified all the data points in the majority class. This is why the accuracy is higher than the proposed algorithm, but the F score and G score are way lower than the proposed algorithm. And in the last experiment on this data set, for sampling rate, a random number between 1 and 1 out of 4 is chosen for the sampling rate, and the statistics of the table show that the proposed algorithm is slower than other classifiers, but has better results than them. And in conclusion, experimental results show that the proposed algorithm has better performance in time series label prediction because it handles the variations of the time spans between each two data points. In this paper, our emphasis is on the relative nature of the time. Unlike the neural network architecture, where the structure is hard-coded and the time span between two data points it is discarded in those algorithms, we try to propose a way that considers those time spans and considers the concept of the time. And proposed algorithms have some problems, which one of them is its processing time, which is more higher than the neural networks. And by addition of each feature to the data set, the proposed algorithm processing time raises more than neural networks. Thank you for your consideration.